the Diamond Sutra question answer session. You mentioned to me that enlightenment is spontaneous, like a flash. However, can you explain why there is difference between enlightenment of one person to the other? There is difference between the enlightenment of Buddha, Muhammad, Osho, Sheikh Nazim, and even yourself. Are there lots of mini enlightenments before one huge one at the end, which stops the cycle of birth, and one attains moksha? It has a couple of questions in it. It is important when someone asks questions like these that shows they are attentive. Now, I have to go back to Mirza Ghalib's one composition. Someone asked him about his poetry. How does the poetry happen? He is sitting down with a piece of paper and pen. He puts the pen to the paper. Thoughts begin to flow. He says, aate hai ye mazami khayal mein ghaib se. He is mentioning that these thoughts that I put on the piece of paper, they come from an unknown and unknowable source. It has nothing to do with me. Sometimes in the process of meditation, when one is touched by the absolute light, or put it this way, one reaches to the moment of a state of no mind, there is no thought arising in the mind. Your consciousness has moved from finite to infinite, from known to the unknown. That moment, something begins to happen. Khalil Gibran and all other writers have experienced that state, but it is not in their hands. Because of certain circumstances and situations, they are pushed into that state, and something begins to happen. In case of Buddha, it is conscious. Consciously he can go into that state. This is one aspect. The other aspect is, you said why there is a difference between the enlightenment of different persons. Enlightenment, if just as the thoughts, or I mentioned the poetry, is a communion between the state of no mind and the faculty through which the no mind expresses itself differs. Khalil Gibran comes from an, is of a Lebanese ancestry, and so is the case with the others. He will know the surroundings of his place. He will talk about cedar trees. He will talk about the things that he has known. So when he is touched by the no mind, or you can say the light touches itself, light has to reflect through something. It needs a reflecting medium. Then your mind, its frame, how the mind has been trained. Then organs of perception and action. When light passes through all these, its color changes. But you remember, it is still the nascent light. It is purest light. It is coming directly from the no mind or the state of inner emptiness. But the reflection will be different because of the reflecting medium. How you develop yourself. For instance, I am living in the West, dealing with the people where English language is the easiest means of communication. I can speak in Hindi, then it will be of less benefit. So I have to attain proficiency in the language which will help me to establish a communion with the people. So whatsoever I will speak, that will reflect in the language which is understood by the masses. The same thing that I am expressing, I can simultaneously express in Hindi language, because that language too I have command on it. But it will not be a translation from English to Hindi or Hindi to English, it will be original within that. So Buddha's frame of mind is different. Now, another example that I will put together. There are different students who go to the university. They are studying for their masters. One does masters in one discipline, the other does it in another discipline. At the end of the year, during the graduation ceremony, each one of them is given a certificate, a degree, which is of masters in science. But along with that, a specification is given: Master of Science in Physics, Chemistry, Biochemistry, because that is the discipline you have chosen and that came naturally to you to go into that field. Existence prepares the students. Why did you go into biochemistry? Because something deep within told you that biochemistry is natural to you and you can gain proficiency in that. Other can gain, has a natural liking towards mathematics or something else. You choose that discipline. You are trained for that discipline. And then your degree that is given to you at the end will differ from that of the other. Muhammad lived in a totally a different kind of environment, different situation, different times. Buddha lived in a different situation, the circumstances were different. Muhammad lived in the deserts, where the intense heat and things like these happened. He will talk about oasis, he will talk about greenery. We always talk about something that we do not experience. Zen, on the other hand, developed in lush green climate of Japan. They have to speak differently. The language that Mohammed will use will be different than that of the Zen monks. To explain this, I will take another example. There is a beautiful place like Switzerland. Those who can afford, they go to Switzerland. So everybody goes for their honeymoon to Switzerland. People from different countries, a German also goes, Britisher, American, all these people. The experience of honeymoon remains the same, but the German will express it in a different way as compared to Swede, as compared to Britisher, because his language is different. He has seen the circumstances and the environment is different. The beauty that a person in the Middle East has seen is the beauty of the desert and the oasis in between. But a person who has lived in a cold country, for him, the snow falling has a beauty. He will give example of that. His narration of the act of honeymoon will be guided by his frame of mind, what he knows about it. There will be difference in the outer expression of all these people, but the inner experience will be the same. So too, when light interacts, comes into you, and it begins to activate your thought process, there is a state of bliss, explosion of bliss or joy, something you have never experienced before, remains the same. As happens in case of honeymoon, when the process completes and the joy explodes, the state of joy or bliss of all the honeymooners remains the same, but their outer expression differs. Outer expression depends on many things, the language that you are accustomed to, the circumstances and situations and examples that you are accustomed to, that you will use to explain the inner state of your joy. So this is the reason that we see the difference between Buddha, the enlightenment of Buddha, Mahavir, Jesus. And you remember, God has not created human beings like Henry Ford creating cars on the assembly line. Each individual is unique. And although we say when a child is born, specifically the elderly ladies, and they will come and say the child is resembling this and that and so, no matter what you do, no two children resemble one another. And whatsoever resemblance you see is your own imagination. God is creator. And creator means each piece is custom made. And when it is custom made, it is totally different, and there cannot be any resemblance existing between the two. When God created the individual so unique, so unique that there is no carbon copy of that at all, then everything that he does has to be unique. When Holy Prophet speaks, there is a uniqueness in his words, in his message. When Buddha speaks, there is a uniqueness in his message. So too is the uniqueness when Osho speaks, how he gives the message. But if you close your eyes and sit down, you will feel as if the experience is the same. Experience never changes, but the outer expression changes. You can take the water from the ocean in the container. Yes, the shape of the container in which it is served is also important. That is why when Chinese serve tea, they serve in a particular kind of a cup. And we have a certain kind of vessel, certain kind of cups to serve the things, but the content remains the same. Whether you serve tea in a blue cup or a green cup or an orange cup, the taste of the tea remains the same, it comes from the same teapot. But when it is presented, the color of the cup will be reflected through the content in it. But it will not change the taste. Will it change taste? No. The taste will remain the same. That because of the outer container in which it is placed, will have its definitely the reflection. Mind is the container. Mind is the container that has its reflection, and because of that, it appears that the enlightenment of different people is different. Their expression is different. If you give a cup of tea to different people, there are different people sitting down in the tea shop. Each one of them tastes the cup of tea, but they will express, if you ask them how they taste, their expression will be different. Taste remains the same. If you go to their very minutely observe their countenance, faces, and you know the art of reading the inner expression through the face, then you will know there is no difference. The difference is only of the expression, and the expression comes because of the upbringing, because of the language and all that you are trained into. This is why the reason it comes in. Now you ask a question about the many stages. Are there lots of many enlightenments before one attains to the? This is true. The word enlightenment was coined by Buddha. Before that, the experience existed, but it was not given the name as Buddha had given enlightenment. So in Zen, they talk about various stages of mini explosions. These are known as satori. is a small window. Now, many times I gave this example. You had come to visit a city in Switzerland. Very beautiful city for holidays. You reached in the night. You have heard about the beauty of Switzerland, that's why you decided to visit this city. You are anxious. You place your luggage into the room. There are couple windows in the room, each opening in a different direction. One opens towards the, I'm just imagining, giving you the example. One opens towards the street where there is traffic, there is light. The next window opens towards an open land. Third opens in another direction. You are very anxious to know, to watch what Switzerland looks like. It is the night, cold winter night. At the most, you can go in the lobby. You can go to the restaurant, you can go to the dining area, but that does not give you the natural beauty of Switzerland. So you try to remove the drape. You cannot open the window because the windows are made in such a way that they cannot open, only the drape could be removed. By removing the drape, you remember window is a particular size. It is fixed in the wall of the room like a frame. It's like, and what you see from outside the window is the framed image of outside. That it excites you. It gives you a joy. You rejoice what you see. You try to see from the corner of the window if you could see a wide angle. You look at it straight. Then you go to the other window and try to look at it again. These are the experiences of the outer through a framed window, framed images of outer Switzerland. But these framed images is not the reality. It is an expression, it is an experience of reality. It gives you, it creates more insatiable quest in you to explore the beauty. And if one window opens towards the mountain side and you see a long range of mountains spread in front of your eyes and it happens to be a moonlight and the moonlight falls, the mountain shimmers, it sends a kind of a feeling within you to explore more. Like that, many situations comes in the process of enlightenment, the final process. These are the framed images, framed image experiences of the experience of interaction between the unknown and an unknowable and the known that you are. These continue to come in life again and again as the process of inward journey has begun. In the beginning they come far and wide, and as you are coming closer, it begins to happen very intense. And one after the other, they keep on coming. It can be explained just as an experience of all. First takes a longer period of time. When first comes, the others follow in quick succession. And then ultimately there is a final explosion as enlightenment. That is why these are known as saturis. They come first far and wide, and all of a sudden they come so much. So it is a preparation for the final explosion to happen. And when the final explosion comes, after that you enter into a state of, put it this way, samadhi, that you are. You cannot. Sometimes that state remains for days together. You don't feel like talking to anyone. You have no hunger. As if you have experienced something. After that, all the physical desires and everything vanishes. Then you have to be slowly and slowly in the company of the monastery brings back to you to the state, because you remember, in order to continue the work of the process of transformation, you have to live and interact among the people. But after that, this experience, something has basically changed. You can never remain the same as you were before. You are living a life as if you are like a guest on this planet. You are here to fulfill your role. The moment your role is over, your boat is ready, anchored, and you are ready to sail to the other shore any moment. You have no attachments here. You have looked at it, the actors acting in the movie. They have been given a script. They have to act in a particular way. They have a screen. Parent, their spouse, and so on and so forth. They interact with one another according to the script that is written. But they are not attached to the script. They know that they are acting only. Each one of you is the seed of awakening. But this seed has to be taken care of. Each one of you is a unique seed. Someone may blossom as a rose, other may blossom as orchid, some may blossom as blue rose or red rose or pink rose, but each one of you has the potentiality to blossom. What is the role of the master in that process? He is the gardener. He continues to nourish and nurture you, that every moment you are being taken care of, so that the process of growth continues. Process of growth, the plant goes through the various stages of its development, And then finally, one day the birds start appearing. First comes one, then comes two, then season of the spring has come. So it is in that process she continues to monitor your progress, takes care of everything and helps you to grow, helps you to grow. This is why you see there is a difference in the outer expression of different people who have attained to enlightenment and how you carry on the post-enlightenment. That too is determined by your inner preparation and the role for which you have been prepared and the role that you have to perform in the process of transformation. Each flower, when it blossoms, it has a role to perform in enhancing the beauty of the garden, in enhancing, adding a new dimension to the beauty of the flower bouquet to which it is added on. It gives its own beauty and fragrance and luster. That is why each is unique, their expression is unique, but inner blossoming is the most important thing. When the light begins to work with a particular bud, light simply activates the process of blossoming of the bud. Whether it is a blue bud or a red bud or an orange bud, enlightenment is the process of blossoming of the bud that you are. What you are trained with, what you carry deep within you, that alone will be manifested when the light interacts with your body, mind, and intellect. A red bud has a different body, mind, and intellect realm as compared to blue, as compared to orange, as compared to orchid or marigold or any other flower. Light simply helps in the process of blossoming. Monat is a different kind of flower, so is Buddha, so is Jesus, so is Osho, or so is Raman, so is Jiddu Krishnamurti, so is Gurdjieff, and the unknown and unknowable, the no mind, the light simply helps the flower, simply helps the process of blossoming. What will happen depend on the innerness of the individual bud or individual being that is being allowed the process of blossoming.